This episode was made possible by generous supporters on Patreon.
Hey, crazies. Let me tell you, light is crazy fast. It travels at 671 million miles per hour. That's 186,000 miles per second, or 300,000 kilometers per second, or 30 centimeters per nanosecond. Whatever units you choose, that's crazy fast. Fast, fast. So fast, it might leave you wondering, how fast is that exactly? Let's do some comparisons. The fastest humans in history were the Apollo 10 astronauts at 0.006% the speed of light. The fastest human-made object was the Juno space probe at 0.025% the speed of light. Andromeda is hurtling toward the Milky Way galaxy at 0.04% the speed of light. All of these are tiny fractions of that 671 million miles per hour. Physicists have really only gotten close to the speed of light with subatomic particles. The record for a proton in the Large Hadron Collider is 99.999999% the speed of light. Now that's fast. Fast, fast. I'm a mad scientist though. We can do better. I have a specially designed rocket just for this purpose. This seems dangerous. I probably shouldn't do this myself. We'll use Rocket Clone. All right. We lost him during the Twins Paradox video. Guess I'll have to make another one. All right, now we have a rocket clone. Let's do this. Say he gradually accelerates away from my space station. Faster, and faster, and faster. How long will it take him to reach light speed? Well, he won't. See, accelerating a rest mass like a person or a rocket requires energy. For example, a rocket transforms energy from its fuel into kinetic energy. It will continue to accelerate as long as it burns fuel. Even if he somehow managed to turn all of the energy in the observable universe into kinetic energy for himself, he'd still only be going 99.999, that's 100 nines after the decimal place, which is still not 100%. It would literally take an infinite amount of energy over an infinite amount of time to accelerate up to exactly the speed of light. It's impossible. That being said, there are things in this universe that go at exactly the speed of light, namely light. And that's any light from the spectrum, not just visible light, but also gravitational waves and anything else without rest mass. Gluons? Anyway, that speed does exist, but the fact that it's impossible for massive objects to reach it has a weird side effect. No matter how fast you go, light will always be faster. 671 million miles per hour faster. Light is so fast that it breaks our understanding of how speed works. How can it always be going the same speed faster than you? Because space-time. We're gonna need a space-time diagram. If you're not familiar with those, you should go check out this video first. All right, let's bring Rocket Clone back for another experiment. If instead of accelerating, he travels at a steady speed, his space-time path will look like this. Let's consider the part between my space station and, I don't know, Wolf 359. They're about 8 light-years apart, and the trip takes about 14 and a half years. We know speed is space divided by time. So 8 light-years divided by 14 and a half years is 0.55 light, or 55% the speed of light. We can draw those measurements as a triangle, which makes the speed the tangent of an angle, but not the tangent you know and love.
Most people don't love trigonometry.
Really?
Yes, really.
Weird. Anyway, this isn't a regular tangent. It's a hyperbolic tangent, or tanch for short. Switching from my point of view to rocket clones requires a hyperbolic rotation. Don't ever forget relativity rule number 3. Huh? Let me just show you. These are my coordinates. These are rocket clones. Me, rocket clone. Me, rocket clone. The space and time axes rotate in opposite directions to line up with the observer taking the measurements. That's called a hyperbolic rotation because the coordinates on each axis move along hyperbolas. The more his path is tipped from mine, the faster he's moving according to me. So let's look at a bunch of different speeds and see what happens. This is stationary. This is 10% the speed of light. Here's 25%, 50%, 75%, 90, 99, 99.9999. Seeing a pattern here? they're approaching this diagonal path. Even the accelerated rocket from earlier approaches it. That diagonal is the path that light would take in space-time, at least if it was traveling the same direction. Both this rocket and this light are traveling to the right. If we sent another set to the left, it would look like this. The angles in here are weird, though. These two angles give us 55% the speed of light, but this angle only gives us 84.5%, not 110%. These two angles give us exactly the speed of light, and this angle also gives us exactly the speed of light. Any angle measured from those diagonal paths will give you exactly the speed of light. Every single one of these angles gives us exactly the speed of light. That is some crazy distortion. The point is that a hyperbolic rotation keeps the speed of light constant. The speed of light is measured to be exactly the same by everyone, no matter what. So here's what we've learned. The speed of light is the upper limit for speed in any direction. It's 671 million miles per hour, which is unimaginably fast. So fast that no matter how fast you go, light will always be faster. 671 million miles per hour faster. And just in case that hasn't completely sunk into your brains yet, even if you're going 670 million miles per hour, light is still going 671 million miles per hour faster than you. That's crazy. So how crazy do you think light is? Let us know in the comments. Thanks for liking and sharing this video. Don't forget to subscribe if you'd like to keep up with us. A special thanks goes out to Patreon patrons like Ilya, Yashin, and Drake Dragon for helping make this show possible. And until next time, remember, it's okay to be a little crazy. For those of you saying you think the acceleration still matters for the twins paradox, well, yeah, sure, it matters, just not in the way people usually say that it does. The acceleration doesn't suddenly explain time differences between observers. It just makes it possible for them to compare notes. Anyway, thanks for watching!